Alright, so what's up everyone, this is Marky. This is gonna be a super long video. Okay, so how to deprogram statists. Long video. So as a statist, do you think taxation is theft? And if they say yes, then they know that they don't get services back for their taxes. It's in taxes for services they think they might get back from the state, all right? And then work your way to more and more complex situations, complex questions. Do you think you can delegate rights you don't have to someone else? Then to 100, then to 10 people, then to 100 people, then to 1,000, then to 1,000,000, then to 300 million, 100 million, 7 billion. Do you think you can delegate a right you don't have to someone else? Can you turn an immoral act into a moral act without changing the law itself? What is it called when you take money from someone else? It's stealing. So even when it's called euthanism, taxation, or civil assets, fortitude, that's still theft. That's still wrong. Redistribution of wealth, it's still wrong. Propping up businesses and big businesses from the taxpayers wrong. Tell them to look up Better Bastiat. Tell them to look up Larkin Road. Tell them to look up Ron Paul. Tell them to look up Tom Wood. Tell them to look up the Mises Institute. Tell them to look up Jesus, because a lot of people claim Jesus was an anarchist. And turn the other cheek. Love their neighbor as itself. Blessed are the peacemakers, shall be the children of God. So like peace, you know, like not being Christian warmongers. Same with your carpet bomb the whole Middle East because they're Muslims and they're scary and blah, things like that. So, use examples in the Bible like blessed are the peacemakers. Another good passage that I think throughout the Bible. Ask them, do they think that politicians have extra rights than anyone else? Are they immuted from basic morality? Are they exempt from basic morality? No, they aren't. They follow the same moral code as anyone else. They own themselves. They choose to participate in the democratic process and the elections and things like that. So they are responsible for the outcomes, whether bad or good, whether good or bad, sorry. Which is 9 times out of 10 is bad. And I'm just doing my job and I'm just following orders. It's no excuse for violence, throwing people in cages, for smoking plants, taking more taxpayer money on it, on politicians' dime, stealing more money from the taxpayers, ripping them off to be exact. So bailout after bailout after bailout without the taxpayers. So it's time to say no to bailout and allow banks to fail, allow institutions to fail. And if you want something bad enough, fund it yourself or pay for it yourself. That's another way to deprogram statists. The politicians are never there to serve your best interest. They are there to serve their interest and their interest only. And they are to enrich and empower themselves at the expense of the taxpayers. So when you see scandal after scandal after scandal after scandal, you realize that politicians ain't needed. That when you get rid of statism, your life is more for you, more or less fear as a result of anyone else who looks different than you, who talks different than you, who practices different religion than you, who doesn't practice religion at all different than you, who has different beliefs than you do, who is associated with different people than you are. You all start to see people as individuals, not as groups. And there's a lot of different ways to deprogram status. But I figured the biggest one is getting them to read Basquiat, Karl Menger, Austrian School, but they don't do a politics or statism. Reading the most dangerous superstition by Larkin Rose. And so if you want to deprogram status, send this video to them. I heard about the warlord option. It's not convincing. I'm in the state of anarchy right now. I'm not bowing to authority, and I don't see any warlord around the corner. I don't see McDonald's turning them into monopoly and violence and forcing me to buy their cheese workers. Otherwise, they go out of business quickly. And so that dismisses the warlord argument. So the statist that the market provides more things than the ineffective, inefficient, and unelectable bureaucracy produces at a slower and bogging down and regulations and taxes and forms to fill out. It's horrendous at the state level. They protect their own and they classify everything. And so that should be getting people heavy skepticism of government, of the state, and the authority in general, the cops, the lawmakers, the lawbreakers, which are you and me. If it's either to break the law or obey the law, it's to break the fucking law and break it every single chance you get. Because they're just threats. That's all they are, just threats. With the backing of violence. That's all political scribbles are, just threats. So once you point that out to statists, then they would be more likely to disobey and not follow the commands of politicians and political scribbles and bureaucracy and bureaucrats. And so look out for Larkin Rose's demure. Having Facebook conversations with people can really get them to wake up, consider a different idea. So having a one-on-one in real life, you can deprogram a statist. You can deprogram a Christian. You can deprogram an atheist. You can convert them to anarchism. You can use different regimes as an advantage to show why government is inefficient, ineffective, and unreliable, and unaccountable to its actions. Scandal after scandal after scandal after scandal. Eventually, that will get people to give up hope, to give up optimism about the government ever being the savior of the world. And you can show the data, mainstream media, lies and fake news, and show them that they're lying, that they're not telling the truth, that they are covering up for some of the world's most violent, psychopathic authoritarians in the world. And they are all doing it because of ratings. And even the ratings can't save themselves, can't save them or themselves from losing loyal watchers, loyal viewers, MSNBC, Fox, ABC, CNN, Disney, Glenn Beck, Bill Riley, all the mainstream media, it still cannot can't keep 110% of the audience. They lost them like so long ago. And you can point to many different things. Wars being ineffective. What the war on drugs is a failure. The war on terror is a failure. The war on poverty. Locking up people for non-victimous crimes. We have the world's largest prison population of the world. We have more people in prison than the rest of the world combined. So you can show the statists history path of communism and socialism, how the common good, and how in the 20th century they killed over 250 million people of their own country, not including war. And we don't want the 21st century to repeat itself, to be more of the same. We want it to be different. We want to be an enlightening path. We want people to wake up to true humanity and care about each other. And showing that anarchy is in chaos, to show that anarchists are not bomb throwers, are not window breakers, are not communists, are not socialists. But we realize that emotional connection, that telling people what we're learning, showing people what real anarchy looks like, and showing people what real anarchists are. And so the exponential growth curve of anarchists is continuing to grow. And so I hope it continues to grow, and it will. And so I hope you guys send it to all the data that you can think of, and get them to think about Murray Rothbard, Mises, Mises Institute, Ron Paul, Tom Wood, Peter Schiff, Larkin Rhodes, Soji the Outlaw, Luca Dowsey of We Are Changed, who else? Lysander Spooner, Immortal Technique, Lupe Fiasco, Words I Never Said, Eminem Moss, So, this is my project on deprogramming as many statists as possible. So show them rock and roll, show them the philosophy of liberty first and foremost before anything else, before asking them anything else. So show them the philosophy of liberty and take them on through that. Self-ownership, the non-aggression principle. No one else may take your life. No one else may take your property. No one else may take you. No one else may take your liberty. Nobody else may take your money. To take your life is murder. To take your liberty is slavery. To take your money is theft. So, two statists about self-ownership and the non-aggression principle, and that will lead them down the path toward the awakening, and there we are on their way. It's all about how you present it. It's about how, what audience you're talking about, and who you're listening to. You have many different strategies, many different methods to combat.
Consider a famous essay by Friedrich Bastiat on the seen versus the unseen, a classic theme in economic reasoning.
Show them Friedrich Bastiat, show them Larkin Road, show them Ron Paul, show them Louis von Mises. Show them the Murray Rothbard. Show them Anatomy of the State. Show them No Treason Constitution. No Treason Constitution of No Authority. Larkin Road is Jones Plantation. Larkin Road is Tiny Dot. The Mule. Candles in the Dark. That'll be going. And, show them all of Larkin Road's work and its books. That should be the light bulb that goes off. That should be the thing that triggers them in awakening. The Creature from Jekyll Island is another good thing. So if that book really sells again, and it gets people to question the Federal Reserve and start getting them to question other things, so they're eventually going down the path and they'll be awake. And it may take a few years, it may take decades, it may take years, but they will come in awakening due to the internet. And I want to reach as many statists, as many of the masses as possible. And so I want to do it in a way that they can understand, they can take away from it, they can better their lives. And not trust politicians, not trust bureaucrats, not trust anyone, but their community, the people they associate with, the church they reside in, the church they don't reside in, the community they don't belong to, or the community they absolutely love and adore. It's all upon the personal perspective, who they value and who they associate with the most. Tom Woods had a huge influence on me. Still now, Ron Paul, Murray Rothbard, Anatomy of the State, which got me to question my statism, No Treason, the Constitution of No Authority, Lysander Spooner, got me to question the social contract and the Constitution, which created the authoritarian ruling class, and things like that. So you gotta know what audience you're working with, you gotta know what people you are catering to, what your audience is, and how you can use them to think about things. And so the only thing I could do is help you guys out and Walter Block, Tom Woods, Frederick Bastiat, Peter Schiff, Iron Schiff, Ron Paul, Mises, F.A. Hayek, Milton Friedman, Norm Singleton, Walter Jones, Rand Paul. He might get you into the libertarian aspect. Maybe in Donald Trump. Maybe you hate Donald Trump so much that you gave up on politics, you gave up on statism, you gave up on the religion of government, and you wanted to become an anarchist. So it may start with somebody like Donald Trump to have you give up statism, to have you give up the belief in authority. Mine was combined between Murray Rothbard and Lysander Spooner. But it's ultimately Larkin and Road that led me to giving up the belief in government and the belief in authority. And it's a faith-based religion. It's worthwhile to deprogram status, and it takes a while, but if you share this video with everyone that is a status or your family members, or videos of Block and Road, share a channel to everyone you know. So I want to keep deprogramming status one by one. And if this video gets popular, then I create another one. So show them Ron Paul, show them Murray Rothbard, show them Walter Block, show them Tom Woods, show them Reason, show them Freedom Works, show them Facebook, show them Edward Snowden, show them Julian Assange of Wikileaks, show them Rand Paul, show them Tim Mullen, Stefan Molyneux's earlier videos in the beginning of his work, Alex Jones, to get you on the right track towards the awakening, Alan Watts, Terrence McKenna, Alma Summers, A-L-M-A, Summers, S-O-M-M-E-R, Alma Summers, Thomas, show them Peaceful Anarchism, show them Seed to Liberty Podcast, show them those type of, show them the podcast, show them podcasts, show them videos, get them to question the military, resist the indoctrination that they're being born into. And to get them to question different things and to question new things they haven't been taught before. And there's a lot of podcasts out there that are waiting to be discovered. There's a lot of people out there that are libertarians on their way to anarchism. There's a lot of people out there that are starting to escape statism for the first time in their life. And after all the discussions and debates and political ritual back and forth, voting, not voting, voting again, expecting different results, and it's more of the same, and they're finally being more independent and more critically thinking. So you want to pursue the libertarian to anarchism bit by bit, day by day. Show them Murray Rothbard. Show them how Murray Rothbard became a libertarian. and show them Tom Wood. Show them Ron Paul. Alright, so I finally got my answer. I've been thinking about what card regardless of the logical argument against it. At this point, I believe it's nearly everything. Media, public schools, peer pressure, who keep people from seeing the light. If we identify a specific thing, perhaps we can come up with plans to store some without aggression, of course. Public schools are obviously a big problem. I would imagine that many of the people have managed to undo the damage public education did. However, we are by far the minority. How can we combat the indoctrination machine? Is it at all possible to use the system to gain access to the schools? Is there perhaps some way that they could be forced to allow anarchist speakers to give presentations in public schools? It's one heck of an uphill battle when there are millions of people. 23 million civilian government workers in 2008, according to the U.S. Bureau of Economic Analysts. National income and productive account table 640 added in the military. We are actually beating at the taxpayer 12. Some think we can starve them out, take away the sources of funding, so those who choose to live on so little that they pay no income tax. That's just a drop in the bucket. They are still paying all the other taxes, property, sales, of course. Perhaps if a few million were to join in, it might be an eyebrow or two, but have any real effect. Personally, we've been buying up lots of copies to the most dangerous superstition, rock and roll, and gave them out to friends, coworkers, acquaintance, anyone who thinks will read it with an open mind, and ask them to pass it on. We think we've seen positive change in some folks. This is good, but it surely takes a long, long time to build up to mean much. I can't help but think that greater minds than mine have tried to find ways to make positive change to figure out, toss this out, and see what happens. Maybe we'll come up with some noble way to nudge things. Talk. It's one heck of a... Unfortunately, that is not a full picture. You need to consider all the indirect government employees, the people that build the schools, maintain the roads, build the weapons, supply the paper even. No one wants to do the comfy government contract. Some think that this would never have a real effect since there are very visible companies that are forced to supply cars. They're giving far more to the government than individuals. They can take advantage of loopholes. The government gets them, but they can't hide. If they refuse to pay, they are gone. It will help fund those involved in the underground market, though, and that is a good thing. Perhaps we've been buying up That is the only way to really change anything, education. People need to see there is a problem. They need to see there are alternatives that are not really as bad as they assume. And there's an uphill battle with new participants every moment, every day. It would be like trying to convert religious people to atheism. There are social systems in place, families to pass it on, and belief with the desire to have to believe. This is why Ron Paul has been so important to the liberty movement. Even though he is not advocating ANCAP, he is exposing the concept of freedom to the world. He exposes the theft and violence of government. I don't advocate running for president in the ANCAP, as people are just annoying ANCAP being so hypocritical. But spreading the message is the key. We never accomplish anything as a few thousand people spreading around the world. I'm a firm believer in sovereign abuse. The only reason the government can do all the things it does is because they have a control over the money. Ron Paul teaches us that, so it should follow that we need to stop using our money. This is why I'm so hopeful for Bitcoin. As individuals, we can play hot potato with the dollar, keeping as much of our money in Bitcoin as possible, and as little in dollars as possible. Do your best to find others who accept payment in Bitcoin. If that means buying your food at local farmers markets and finding those who accept Bitcoin, so be it. Support businesses who support Bitcoin. The wonderful thing about Bitcoin is it's appeal to both conservatives and liberals. With conservatives, you tell them it's free market money. With liberals, you can tell them it's the people's money. If you can get to the point in your life where 100% of what you make and spend in Bitcoin, then you are starting to be, in my opinion. I think it took about 10 thousands of people 100% on Bitcoin to make a dime, maybe more. Sure, it's something, and eventually maybe it'll work. But I think the black gray market has a better chance of starving the beast, so you don't have to convince anyone to change the currency they use. I'm not sure. It depends how quickly it happens. The other day, I was thinking about moving my money around since my bank is looking a little bit shaky, to say the least. I thought about what a joke FDIC it really is. Then I realized that running a bank in the U.S. would lead to runs on other banks, and FDIC either wouldn't be able to pay out, or they'd have to get help funding it. Either way, I thought that not being one could lead to financial Armageddon, that tens of thousands of people going 100% Bitcoin could change the world, depending on who those people are and how quickly it happens. In the discourse of statists, there is a group of phrases that with the one or more tend to be present in nearly every argument. When this is not an exhaustive list of the proof, it does contain 25 of the most common phrases that statists use in their argument. As propaganda, the tendency will be repetitive. Some of these phrases contain the same logical fallacies and with a similar refutation. As such, the phrases are ordered to the earlier rebuttals also apply to some later phrases. Our government. Our is a passive form of we. This phrase assumes that a collective exists and that the ownership of the government, which is another collective. To exist is to have a concrete, particular form of physical reality. To say that abstract objects exist is back to the question of where they exist. To which there is no answer because there is no empirical observable entity. To say that collective exists is back to the question of what physical form they take. As all physical forms are occupied by individuals who are said to comprise the collective. Thus, there is no we, there is only you, I, and every other individual person. By the same token, government does not exist. Each person, each building, each gun is just, and the death phase, our government is meaningless. Additional to own something is to have a right of exclusive control of it. Part and parcel of this right to a right to stop physically destroying that which one owns. As government uses force to stop citizens who attempt to physically destroy the state, the citizens are not de facto owners of government. We are the government. This place computes society of government, which is serious enough to compute an entire human body with a magnetic, monogenic tumor growing inside of that body. The social contract. A valid contract must be tended honesty and greed to voluntarily without distress or fraud. The social contract does not meet the standard because the state will initiate your support against anyone who does not voluntarily enter the social contract. The state is also not automatically dissolved when it fails to uphold its obligation under the social contract. So the presentation is dishonest if it even occurs at all. Therefore, the social contract cannot be considered a legitimate contract. Our leader, in the case of a state, we are not speaking of just any kind of leader, but a ruler. No one owns the ruler, and the ruler falsely claims to own those who are ruled. And as the ruler claims the right to exclusive control of the world, and has no logically defensive basis for doing so, thus the ruler is not ours. The leader of the free world. The free world does not exist. Each individual person exists. Again, we are speaking of rulers rather than all types of leaders. Free people do not have rulers, they have ruled themselves. You don't have to like our leaders, but you should respect them. Respect should be responsible virtue. Ordering the use of initiatory force against people to control them is not virtuous behavior. Therefore, it is unworthy of respect. You don't have to like the president, but you should respect the office of the presidency. The office of the presidency, like any other part of any government, is a violent criminal institution. Violent criminality is unworthy of respect. Our military. If the military is ours, then we should be able to exercise exclusive control, but we neither command the military nor have the freedom to destroy it. Thus, it is not ours. It is the tool of the ruling class used to make it very difficult for citizens to violently overthrow the government. Perhaps the last part of the defense is by the state in the form of martial law should be citizens to succeed in violently overthrowing the government and presenting a return to other rulers elsewhere in the world who might seek to take over the state and capture tax base for themselves. We need to make the world safe for democracy. Democracy is too warped in the chief voting on what who's getting eaten. The sort of behavior should not be made safe. It should be dangerous by giving the chief means to resist the war. Some would say this is what a constitutional republic does, but this is false. A constitutional republic is three wolves and a sheep voting for a representative. Among them decide who gets eaten. The claim that establishing a constitutional republic counters the negative aspect of democracy to claim that simply by making a chocolate cake double layered, one can magically turn it into something that is not chocolate. You have to like what the police and military are doing, but you should support them. Again, respect should be responsible to you. Just in order to use the initial report to give people to control of not virtuous behavior. Carrying out such orders is not virtuous. Therefore, it is unworthy of respect. The homeland, our nation, as only individuals are capable of acting, only individuals may rightly own property. There is nothing as public property. There is only privately owned property and property which has been stolen or otherwise interfered with by agents of the state. Thus, there is no homeland in the nation because it requires collective ownership. National defense security. There is no such thing as national security apart from each individual person's security. And there is no such thing as a nation apart from each individual person. It's the law. In a state of society, laws are the collection of opinions written down by psychopaths. Humanity either win popularity contests or murder their competitors enforced at gunpoint by thugs in costumes. The implication of the phrase "it's the law" is also the state of affairs. It's both necessary and proper rather than inherently illogical. In a state of affairs, it's both necessary and proper rather than inherently illogical and immoral. Autumn pie is lost in my sacred sand and immutable, which is clearly false because the aforementioned talk about both frequently alter the laws and will sooner discard the laws and make government up. Voting is your voice in government. The statement assumes that there is no voter fraud, but voters are counted correctly, that both results cannot be altered by court, and a politician would do what the voters tell them to do. Even if these assumptions had an unfulfilled burden of proof about it, demonstrated fault on several occasions at work. Voting is a civil duty. A legitimate duty can only come from a legitimate right or contract. There's no such right or contract that creates such a duty. In addition, there can be no legitimate duty to perform an immoral act. Voting is immoral because it helps to impose violent rules upon people and give the appearance of legitimacy to institutions that deserve them. If you don't vote, you don't have no right to complain. This is exactly wrong. People do not vote are the only ones who have the right to complain. Those who vote for people win elections or those politicians and their minions to engage in activities under the color of law that would be punishable crimes if you and I did them. Those who vote for people who lose elections may not be responsible for the crimes of state agents in the same degree, but participating in the system helps to create the appearance of legitimacy, which is inherently illegitimate. The public good, the good of society. Society of the public does not exist. Each individual person exists. As such, there is no such thing as public good or the good of society. There is only what is good for each individual person. For the children. Those who wield power subject children to force indoctrination that leaves them with few marketable skills and restrict the ability of suitable guardians to serve as their parents. They do not care about children as anything other than the means to shame and guilt people and the handing over more liberty and property to the state. Government is not the state. Such as a positive claim is carried a burden of proof. By itself, this is a claim asserted without logical evidence and therefore be dismissed without logical evidence. Anarchy is chaos. The word anarchy comes from the Greek word meaning without rulers, or more accurately, without being or beginning to take the lead. It does not mean an absence of order, rules, or structure. The state, on the other hand, is chaos plus organization. Taxes are the price for a civilized society. This is exactly wrong. Taxes are the price for failing to create a civilized society based on voluntary solutions, and the degree of taxation corresponds to the degree of failure. Paying taxes is a civil duty. Taxation is immoral because it violates the non-aggression principle, private property rights, and the freedom of association. There can be no legitimate duty to comply with immorality. We owe it to ourselves just to make one both the creditor and the debitor in the same transaction. This is a contradiction, therefore it's false. We're going to hold them accountable. Since this country is the nation of a state, the state apparatus allows some people to do what is ordinarily forbidden for anyone else to do. Thus, the objective is the board's responsibility for the commission of crimes. The board's responsibility is the opposite of being held accountable. Who would build the road? Be free or slave, pure picky cotton, it does not matter. What matters is that slavery is morally indispensable. So with government and will provide services in its absence, long also is not necessary to know the correct answer to the question in order to know the particular answer is incorrect. And who will build the death camp? The state also provides intolerable services which are ultimately sort of not occur in its absence. So I just refuted 25 data claims, right? An article I copied and pasted the article in this video, and it's just my long-held project of deprogramming statists. And there's only individuals. There's not a society. There's not the public good. There's not our government or anything like that. That is just an illusion. There's only individuals doing pursuing action. Only individuals act. Only individuals take action to aggress or not aggress against other people.